examination, as well as this this particular concept will be asked in the theory part also. So let's start with the algorithm, students. I will repeat the thing because the students told the voice is not audible. So I will start with the quick shot again. So let's see the quick shot. So here we are having totally 8 elements: 6, 5, 3, 1, 8, 7, 2, 4. So in this, among this element, we are selecting the pivot element randomly. The pivot element 3, whatever we are showing, that will be picked randomly. And from the pivot element, we are able to compare the results. As I told, the pivot element, whatever you are seeing, the left hand side of the pivot element will be lesser than the pivot element. Whatever the value you are putting in the left hand side, that should be lesser value. The right hand side, whatever you are seeing, that should be greater element. So whatever the comparisons we have to do, that have to be start with the pivot element. So we have to compare with the value from the pivot element. So here we are checking whether the 6 and 2. So 2 is less than the 3, so that we are interchanging. So it will go to the sixth position where the 6 is available, the value 6 is available, and 6 will go to this position. So the 2 will come to the 0th position, and again we are comparing. When you are comparing, 1 is very less than 3, so that 1 will become here, and 5 will go to the third position. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So third position 5 will go, and first position 1 will come. Again we have to compare the left hand side values. We are having values. So when you are comparing, 1 is less than 2, so that 1 will be put in the first 0th position, and 2 will come to the first position. The same way we have to compare the right hand side values. When you are comparing the right hand side values, we have to put the least value. So in the first comparison, when you are comparing the 5 and 4, 4 is the least value and 5 is the highest value, so that it will be interchanged. So 4 will come to the third position, 5 will go to the seventh position. The same way again we are comparing the next value, the next least value we have to compare. The next least value to the 4 is 5 actually. Next greater value to the 4 to 4 is 5 actually. So that we are comparing the value. So 8 is greater value and 5 is least value. The pivot element is 6 in this case. So 5 will become here and 8 will go there. Again, when we are comparing, the 7 is greater than 6, so that it will do the interchange here itself. So the pivot element will play the major role. So every time we are identifying the pivot element and interchanging the values. So according to this particular comparison, it will just take the comparison when you are doing the divide work only. It will in the other thing, when you are dividing the values, when it's merging actually, the particular sorting will be happened. But when you are doing with quick sort, in the divide part only, it will just do the sorting and it will do the proper way. So first pivot element is 3, and it will compare and it will identify the values. So when you are seeing the values in the left hand side, less than 3 will be appear, and in the right hand side greater than 3 will be appear. So that is the first case of comparison. So you have to interchange the values according to the pivot element. So pivot element will be compared further and it will just interchange the values one by one. So when you are moving for the next pivot element, so according to the pivot element, it will compare the values. So wherever you are fixing the pivot element, the left hand side should be lesser values and the right hand side should be greater values. So in this case, pivot element will be taken randomly, and it can be taken median value. We can take median value as a pivot element, and we can take the starting value as pivot element, and we can take the ending value as pivot element. These four cases we can able to apply for pivot element. So next to that, here they are fixing the 5, 2. This case, when they are taking the 4, they are taking as a pivot element. So 4, when they are taking, when they are compared with the first value, 4 is lesser value and 5 is the greater value. Again, what they are doing, they are just finding the next pivot element. When they are finding the next pivot element, 6 is the next pivot element. So when they are again comparing with the 6, 5 is lesser than 6, so that they are moving again, and 8 will come to the last position. When this comparison, again they will check with 6 and 7. So in this case, 6 is the least number, so that will go to this position, and 7 will come to the next position. So this way the interchange will happen. So now let's see the PPT so that we can able to understand how the thing happens here. I will close the presentation of this GIF file. So let's go for the presentation of PPT. Students, are you able to see the PPT?
Yes,
Students,
sir.
Are you able to see the PPT? Okay. So we are discussing on the quick shot. That is, you can see how many algorithms we discussed. This is the fourth algorithm. Further, we are having matrix multiplication algorithm. We are having decrease and concur approach and topological sort. These are the algorithms. This model two, not only model two, apart from model one, remaining all models, we are having only algorithms. We have to deal with algorithms, all different algorithms. We have to learn properly. These algorithms we have to write in the VT examination. VT examination question will come only in asking of algorithms. You have to write the algorithm. Don't think of, you can skip the algorithm and you can write something else. You have to write the algorithm properly. You have to elaborate the particular quick shot or match shot or binary search in the form of example. You have to give your own example and you have to identify the result. All these things you have to do. Otherwise, they will give one problematic example. For that, you have to identify the match shot or quick shot, whatever it may be. So think of the different varieties, how the questions will be asked in the VT examination. So let's go for the slide. So let's go for this quick shot. So as I told, it's a type of divide and conquer method. So when the shorting will be occurred in the division part only, so conquer part will not occur. So time complexity will be very less compared to other algorithms. It will execute in very faster manner compared to other algorithms. That is the major benefit of quick shot algorithm. So this is invented by the British scientist named Tony Hoare. So he is a person invented the particular algorithm. He will compare with the previous shorting methodologies, what and all we are having, and he identified that there will be a solution for this, and the time complexity he can able to reduce, so that he identified this particular algorithm. So next to this, let's see how this algorithm works. As I told, this algorithm will be worked with the particular shorting methodology. We are identifying a pivot element. So pivot element will identified with use of the four conditions. As I told, it can be selected randomly, it can be taken as the first element of the array or last element of the array, or it can be a median value. These are the four values, four conditions we can able to make the median value next to pivot element. Next to that, if the n value is one, whatever the n value we are having, if it is one, it can be only single value, single element. If the n value is one, mean by the array is single, single element, then what happens? The same value will be repeated as it is. Whatever the array element we are having, the same value is repeated as it is. And if n value is greater than one, what happens? We are not having this choice of selecting the same element, so that we have to go for identifying the pivot element and we have to compare the element with the pivot element. So here, what is the condition? Actually, we have to identify the pivot element. So less than the pivot element, whatever we are having, that will be less than the value. Whatever the right hand side you are seeing, a of 0 to a of s minus 1, these under all the values are less than a of s. A of s is the pivot element. Keep in mind, a of s is the pivot element. What and all the values you are having in the left hand side, all are said to be less than the pivot element. What and all the values you are having the right hand side, what you are having, a of s plus 1 until a of n minus 1. These are the values you are having. Those values are come under greater than the pivot element value. Those values are come under greater than the pivot element. So this identification we have to do properly. So this is the need of pivot. This is the need of pivot. So next to that, we have to identify the pivot element here. In this, pivot element will be identified so that the shorting will be occur here. The same way in this right hand side, we are identifying the pivot element so that again shorting will be occur here. So this way the quick shot will work. So when the element is single element, we can consider n is equal to 1 so that the same value will be come as it is. If the n value is greater than 1, then we have to apply the pivot element concept and we have to do the shorting. Okay, next to that, let's see how it works, the algorithm, how it works. So what is the algorithm? We are having quick shot A of L to R. So this is the length of the array. The array is A, the starting element is L, and the ending element is R. That is the way we are giving the method. The method of the particular program is quick shot method. So next to this, what is the thing? It will the necessity of quick shot, it will use for shorting the given array using quick shot methodology. Whatever the array you are giving, that will be shorted and it will be displayed in the incremental order. The output will be displayed in the incremental order. Next to this, we are having the input. What is the input actually? We are having subarrays. So subarray of A of 0 to n minus 1, we are having the left hand side and right hand side in positions will be represented with use of L and R. So the left hand side of the array will be L, and the right hand side the element will be R. That is meant by the starting element and the ending element, A of 0 and A of n, whatever the last value, that will be represented with use of L and R. Now what is the output? We are getting the sorted subarray. So A of L to R, that will be sorted in the non-decreasing order. So whatever the array we are having, that will be sorted properly and it will be represented as output. So how it will happen? So what we are doing, we are checking whether the L value is less than R value. If the L value is less than R value, then we have to go for the sorting. So what happens? We are just finding the partition. So we are splitting the positions according to the position. The quick sort will be applied for the left hand side and the right hand side. When you are splitting, the pivot element will be identified. According to the pivot element, we are identifying the left hand side and right hand side. For this left hand side, we are applying the quick sort again, and for the right hand side, we are applying the quick sort. This is the algorithm we are writing for quick sort. Okay. Now, how to do the partition? So partition, you know, we are identifying the pivot element. According to the pivot element, the partition happens. The pivot element will play the major role. It will be in the mid of the thing. Left hand side, right hand side, it will take and it will start the thing. So if there is no left hand side, it will check only the right hand side. The same way, if there is no right hand side, it will check only the left hand side. Like that, it will happen. So the selection criteria of pivot will be three types, as I told. It can be chosen randomly, and we are having option of selecting the first element, last element, and the median value. So we can use a sophisticated method, and we can able to make the quick sort. The subarray of the first element will be stored as a pivot element. This is the way we can able to make. As I told, the first element can be taken as a pivot element. They taken p is equal to a of I. Now the subarray can of the both sides, we can take when you are taking the subarray, the both sides of the particular elements will be compared, and it will be arranged according to the order. Next to this, let's see the example. So how the pivot element will be taken and how the things will be notified. So for this example, they are not given the solution, so we will solve this. Let's take 40 20 10 80 60 50 7 30 100. Students, please note down the example. Please listen carefully. Let's fix 60 as a pivot element. 60 as the pivot element. Now how the values will be compared? Please listen, students. Let's take 60 as the pivot element. So what happens? This side 40 will be compared. 40 is less than 60 or not? 40 is less than 60 or not, students?
Yes, sir.
Please listen. 40 is less than 60. So there will be no interchange. When you are taking this side, what happens? 100 is there. 100 is less than 60? 100 is less than 60?
No.
100 is not less than 60. Next to that, 30 is less than 60?
Yes.
30 is less than 60?
Yes.
Yes, 30 is less than 60. But when you are comparing with 40, when you are comparing with 40, is it greater value or lesser value?
Lesser value.
Lesser value. Then again, we have to move further. We have to identify whether any more elements we are having lesser than 30, we have to identify, so that we have to move further. So here we are having 7. So 7 we are having, 7 will be less than 60 or less than 60 or greater than 60? 7 will be less than 60 or greater than 60?
Less than 60.
So that what we have to do, 7 will be the least element in the comparison. Next we are having 50. 7 will be the least element, so that there will be interchange. 40 will become to the position of 7 will become to the position of 0, and 40 will become to the position of 7. So what happens? We are doing the interchange. So zero here, zeroth position 7 will be there. 20, 10, 80, 60. Again here, 50. Here it will be 40. So next to this, next checking we have to do. In the next checking, what we are doing, 7 will be taken.
So you could have interchanged 30 itself, no? Because even 30 is less than 40. Even
so we have to take the entire values one by one. It will check in this, which is the least one that it will identify. That will be take for the interchange. So it will not stop with 30. Next value it will go for. It will go for the least value in the left hand side. That will be interchanged. The same way here also it will identify the least value. So next case after 7, it will identify with the, it will start with the 7 and will identify whether there is any value that is greater than 7. So in this case we are having in the next case we are having 10. Actually 10 will be the next greater value come to 7. So there will be a interchange with 20. When we are moving the interchange, the 7 will be fixed, the next value will be compared with 10. So 20 will be compared with 10. So 10 will be go to the next position and 20 will be come to the first position. This particular exercise I will solve and share in the Google Classroom so that you can able to understand how it will be happened. So the same way what we see in the GIF file, it will happen. So I will solve this and I will send you in the particular Google Classroom so that you can able to understand properly. In this way, if I'm telling in oral way, it's difficult to understand and it will make you confused. I will solve this and I will share in the Google Classroom students. So next, let's see the partition of this particular quick shot. So here the partition will be happened according to the pivot element. So pivot element, how we are making all you know. So the input is the subarray A of 0 to n minus 1. A of 0 to n minus 1 mean by the first part what we are having in the entire element. This is the first part. A of 0 to A of n minus 1, they are given. This is the left hand side of your given problem. Whatever the problem you are having, the left hand side of the problem will be taken like this. So the left and right indices are L and R. So what is the starting of your element is L and ending of the element is R. So L should be less than R. That is the first condition. That is the input what you are giving. What is the output? Partition of A of L and R with split position returned as this function's value. So it will be shorted value. Whatever the left hand side you are passing to the algorithm will short the values and just give the shorted array as output. So here A of L will be the pivot element. When you are passing this A of L, the first position of the given subarray, that will be taken as a pivot element. P means pivot element. I value will be 1. So I value will be L. J is equal to R plus 1. So this is the starting initial value for I and J they are initializing. So what is L value represents zeroth position, no? So L value 0 will be stored in I. J tends to R plus 1. R value, what is R value? R value will be the last value of the array. For example, if the array size is 5 plus 1, so that will be the J value. Okay, so here we are just taking this particular I and J allocation and we are repeating the same process. What the process we are repeating? We are identifying whether the pivot element is greater than A of I and A of J is less than or equal to pivot element. We are identifying this and we are moving the position of the pivot element. According to the position, we are identifying whether the pivot element value is greater than A of I. A of I value is greater than pivot element and A of J value is less than or equal to pivot element. That checking we are doing here. And according to this checking, if the condition is true, we are just swapping the elements. So the greater element will go to the greater place and the smaller element will come to the starting point of the array so that we can able to arrange the particular values in the form of incremental order. Now, until I greater than or equal to J, we have to repeat the process and we are just swapping the A of I and A of J and we are swapping the A of L and A of J. This is for the last, when you're having a single element in the particular array, we have to go for this final swap. So whatever the array size, according to that, the swapping will take long time. If your array size is more than 50 or 100, according to that, the swapping will go further and further. So it will take a long time, and the time complexity will be increased when your n size is greater. And when you are comparing the time complexity with other algorithms with quickshot, it will be very less, because quickshot will do the identification of shorting process in the dividing level only. So comparing to other algorithms, quickshot will give a faster input and faster computation compared to other algorithms. So let's see this particular example. I hope you will try to understand this particular example, how it's happening, all these things. So let's see, we are having 0th position, 1st position until 7th position, we are having the value. So 5, 3, 1, 9, 8, 2, 4, 7, these are the values we have to short out. So what is the thing they are doing? L value, so mean by L value is 0, L value represents the starting position, R value represents the ending position. So S value is equal to 4. So what is the S value actually? What is the S value we are having? So S value mean by the pivot element. So the pivot element what we are having is 4. So when we are taking pivot element as 4, we can able to make the further move. In the further move, what they are making actually, L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 3. So L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 3. When you are making the pivot element as 4, this part will be come in the left side and this part will be go in the right side. So 0 until 3 we are having the sub node and sub array, and 5 to 7 you can see the L will be 5 and the R will be 7, that will become the right hand side. So here again the pivot element they are fixing as 1, so S is equal to 1. When you are fixing S is equal to 1 among this 0 to 3, what will be the other left part will be this 0 0. So we are having only one element in the left part. Right side, we are having 2 and 3. So L will be 2 and R will be 3. So when you are having a single element, there is no pivot element. We are taking that value as it is. When you are taking the right hand side 2 and 3, we are fixing the pivot element as 2. When you are fixing pivot element as 2, what will be the left node and what will be the right node? When you are fixing this as a pivot element, we are having L is equal to 2 and R is equal to 1. That is the L and R, and here we are having L equal to 3 and R equal to 3, because here when you are fixing the pivot element as 2, so 2 to 3 we are fixing the pivot element as 2. So what happens, we have to keep the left hand side and right hand side for this particular pivot element as 3 only. For right hand side we can able to fix the same element 2 and R value will be 1, like that. So here in this case L equal to 5 and R equal to 7. No, here we are fixing the pivot element as 6. When you are fixing the pivot element 6, what and all the values we are having? So 5 and 7 we are having. In this 6 is the pivot element. So in the left hand side we are having 5, right hand side we are having 7. So that what they are given here, L is equal to 5, R is equal to 5, they are given here. And the right hand side what we are having, L is equal to 7, R is equal to 7. So here there was a mistake, L is equal to 2, R is equal to also 2, L is equal to 3, R is equal to 3. So R value will be 2 here, there was a mistake. Students, did you understand this tree structure, how they formed this tree from the given value?
Sir, can you explain once again, sir?
So here we are having the entire given array. So 5, 3, 1, 9, 8, 2, 4, 7. This is the values we have to apply the quick shot. Let's see 0 and the positions what we are having is totally 8 numbers we are having, so that we have to represent as 0 to 7. Okay. So we have to take, as per the algorithm, the first element will be L, last element will be R. Okay, that what the understanding we got. And yes, here what they are representing as, yes, as a pivot element. There are three variables here. One is L, another one is R, another one is S. So these three variables, what they are doing is, they are applying for the algorithm, and with use of these variables, they are forming this tree. So what they are doing at first level, L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 7. They are taking the first position, L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 7. And what happens, they are keeping the pivot element as 4. So what is the pivot element? Pivot element is this one, 4. So what you can see, so when you are taking the pivot element as 4, how many positions you are having the left hand side? How many elements you are having the left hand side? How many array positions you are having in the left hand side? When
four,
you are
sir.
taking pivot element as four? Four
Four.
elements. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four elements you are having. How many elements you are having in the right hand side? How many elements
Three,
you are
sir.
having in the right hand side? Three.
Three.
Okay. So when you are going for the left hand side, when you are taking this four, what is the L and what is the R? What is the L and what is the R?
0 and 3.
Zero and three.
0 and 3. That what they given here. So left hand side, the L value is 0 and R value is 3. And again, they are fixing the pivot element as 1 here. Okay. Let's finish the left hand side first. Again, they are fixing the S value as 1. So that is the pivot element. So when they are fixing the pivot element as this. So only 4 elements we have to consider. 0, 1, 2, 3. The pivot element is 1. Can you tell me how many values in the left hand side and how many values in the right hand side when you are fixing the pivot element as 1?
One in left hand side.
When you are fixing the pivot element as 1, only one element in the left hand side. How many values in the right hand side, pa?
2, sir.
2. Very good. Because we are having 2 and 3, so that 2. So what is the L value and what is the R value? What is the L value? What is the L value for this particular position?
0, sir.
0. 0 is the L value. What is the R value?
1.
1. R value?
3, sir.
3. So, no, when you are taking this particular pivot position, you have to consider the L value and R value. L value for this and R value for this. And this side, L value and R value you have to identify. So, when you are considering only single element, L value and R value will be same. So that they are mentioning L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0. Did you understand this? So when you are taking 1 as a pivot element, we are splitting. There is only one left node and there is two right nodes. Okay. So when you are fixing this, when you are finding the L and R for this particular node, L value and R value will be same because there is only one element. So that we have to fix L value is equal to 0 and R value is equal to 0. For this side, we are having two elements. So that we have to fix the L value as 2 and R value as 3. Got my point or not? Did you understand this this step?
Sir, how do you take pivot value, sir? On which basis, sir?
So pivot value will be taken randomly. The three condition I told, no, pivot value will be taken randomly, or the median value you can take, or the first element you can take, or last element you can take. That is the random thing chosen by the algorithm. So
yes,
when they are fixing the pivot value as 1, we are having left hand side as 0 and right hand side as two array positions, that is 2 and 3. So when you are identifying the L and R for this particular position, we are having only one element, so that we have to put L value as 0 and R value as 0. Did you got this point? Did you got this
yes,
point?
Sir.
L value and R value is 0.
Yes,
and when you are taking this side, we have two elements. So L value will be 2 and R value will be 3. Did you got this? L value will be 2 and R value will be 3.
Yes,
so further we are not able to split this single element because there is only one element. Here we are having two elements so that we can able to split. For this, they are fixing the pivot element as 2. When they are fixing pivot element as 2, so this is one element, pivot element is one element. So right hand side we are having one element, so there is no left hand side element. The pivot element what you are having, that has to be taken. So for this pivot element position, what is the L value and what is the R value? What is the L value and
L
what
value
is R
to
value?
R value is 3.
No, there is only one node. Only one node we are having. So pivot element we are having. Pivot element, and this is not the midpoint. Pivot element only the midpoint. There is no left hand side we are having. Only the pivot element this side.
2 and 3.
And right hand side we are having 3. So pivot element has to be splitted here. When you are taking only the pivot element, the L value and R value will be same only. So L will be 2 and R will be also 2. Here there is a mistake actually. R is equal to 2. Okay. So when you are taking 3, what happens actually? The right hand side, there is only one element. So here the same L value and R value for this particular element will be 3, 3 only. What my point? If there is a single element in the particular array, the L value and R value will become as it is. If there is a pivot element, for that also the L value and R value will become as it is. So we are having the L value what we are having for the particular position, that will be the same for L and R. Anybody have doubt in this?
Yes, sir.
Can you repeat s equal to like pivot value when
Okay.
it is 2, how do you take that?
So s equal to 2 we are having. This is a mistake actually. So s is equal to 2 we are having, no? So what is the first position? 2 and 3. For 2 and 3, we are fixing 2 as a pivot element. Okay? We are fixing 2 as a pivot element. In this case, we have to take L and R for the pivot element only. There is no split up here. So when you are taking the L and R for pivot element, L will be also 2 and R will be also 2. When you are taking this position, when we are having only single node, so that we have to take the particular node value as L and R. So L value 3, R value also 3.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now let's see the right hand side. Right hand side, we are having 3 elements, 5, 6 and 7. So 5, 6 and 7, again, we have to split. So here, what they are having, L value is 5 and R value is 7. They are fixing the pivot element as 6. So when they are fixing pivot element as 6, can you tell me how many nodes we are having in the left hand side? How many node we are having, array position we are having in the left hand side?
One.
How many array position we are having in the right hand side?
One.
So now, according to this particular pivot position, what is the L value and what is the R value?
5 and 7, sir.
5 and 5.
5 and 5, because we have to take this position. We have only one position. So 5, L value will be 5 and R value also 5. When you are taking this position, we are having only one single node. So this, it will take us L value as 3, L value as 7 and R value as 7. So when you are having a single node, that will be splitted as it is. So the same value will become for L and same value will become for R. For that reason only we are taking the pivot element. If there is no L, in the previous case, what happens? There is no left side here. For this particular pivot element, we have both left hand side and right hand side, so that we are directly taking 5. For 5, we taken as L value as 5 and R value as 5. When you are taking the 7, when you are taking, we are keeping L value as 7 and R value as 7. When you are coming this side, when you see this particular split up, L is equal to 2, R is equal to 3. When you're fixing the S value as 2, for 2 and 3 we have to take. In this case, 2 is the pivot element. For this 2, there is no left hand side. So the pivot element has to be splitted further. So when we are taking the pivot element, so L value for the particular pivot element is 2 and R value for the particular pivot element is 2. So that what they are mentioning here. When you are taking 3, there is only one element in the right hand side. So that 3 has to be splitted again. So L value will be 3 and R value also 3. So keep in mind, students, when you're having a single element in that way, when you're identifying the starting node and ending node, it will be the same node. Any doubts in this, sir, students?
There are two only taken as left and right, no, sir? Pivot.
Louder.
The pivot louder. Element two only taken as... Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Pivot element two only taken as left and right, no, sir?
For this position you are telling. For this position you are telling.
Yes, sir. It is only taken.
So when you are
left
taking
and right.
Yeah, pivot element. When you are taking pivot element 2, there is no left hand side for this pivot element. Got
yes,
my
sir.
Point. There is no left hand
yes,
side for this pivot element. So pivot element has to be splitted further. So for this particular position, when you are taking the pivot element as 2, the left hand side will become as 2, R L will be 2 and R will be 2 only. For this side,
yes,
we are right hand side, we are having one element, so that this particular element will be splitted further. So L value will be 3 and R value will be 3. Can you move for the next slide, students? Okay. So what is the key operation for this particular algorithm? Analysis for this algorithm. The basic operation for this algorithm is key comparison. Key comparison mean by what? Whatever the value, pivot value we are taking, that will be compared with the left hand side and right hand side values. So according to the comparison, it will allot the short the values in a particular position, and it will do the swapping also. So here the best case, all the splits happen in the middle by subarrays. So depth of recursion in log base base 2 power n, okay? So here what we can tell is, if the comparisons for the all the values whatever we are having, it happens within the single pivot element, then we can tell that as a best case. So best case will be represented, the best case formula is represented as C of best of n equal to 2C best n divided by 2 plus n. So n greater than 1, C of best of 1 is equal to 0. If there is a single element, then it will be 0. There is no quick shot will be allotted for that. It will be taken as it is. When we are having more than 1, when the elements are more than 1, we have to apply the formula. So C suffix best of n is equal to 2C suffix best of n divided by 2 plus n. This is the way we can able to make our master theorem. So master theorem for this particular quick shot will be represented as theta of. So the master theorem for this, am I audible now, students? Theta of n log 2 base n we have to give for the master theorem. This is the notation for quick shot. So here the worst case, if the thing is already shorted, when the thing is already shorted, again if you try to short, that will be come under worst case algorithm. So again we have to do all the process. So this is one drawback. If you are giving a shorted list to the quick shot, that will be come under worst case. So here next to this we are having the worst case analysis. So worst case analysis is what they are representing. Actually the entire algorithm is already shorted, and that is given as a input to the quick shot algorithm. Again the process will be happen and it will do, and the worst case notation will be represented in the form of theta of n square. Theta of n square, the best case for quick shot algorithm will be represented as theta of n log base 2n, and the worst case for the quick shot will be represented as theta of n square, so that we can able to make the analysis for average case. The average case algorithm will be represented as n2 minus 1 and minus s. So here we are having left side array, left side subarray and right side subarray, and we are having the comparisons for the average case will be n plus 1 comparisons it have to do, and it will be taking the first position as 0 and the pivot element as s, and the last position as n minus 1. So the pros and cons of quick shot will be good average case time complexity will be there, and the cons will be it's not stable algorithm, and it requires a stack to short parameters of subarray that are not yet to be shorted. You have to give unshorted array as an input for this algorithm, and the algorithm is not stable. Not stable means it will not work for all the conditions like that they are telling. And you can fix the algorithm for a particular problem. So it will be not stable. And we can go for the pros. Pros will be in the average case also the algorithm will be having good time complexity. It will execute the particular problem in very faster manner like that they are telling. So quick shot, I hope you understand. And I will solve the quick shot problem what I shown to you, and I will share in your Google Classroom. Now I will take the attendance and I will conclude this class, students. A section students, give your attendance first. Attendance, give it first. Students, are you able to see the screen what I shared with you? Students, are you able to see the screen what I shared with you?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now? Okay. So give your attendance, students. Give it fast so that we can complete it. 50. 19. 22.
Present, sir.
1.
Present, sir.
3. 4. 5.
Present, sir.
6. 7. 8.
Present, sir. You're right.
9.
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
10. 9. 9.
Present, sir.
10.
11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16.
Present, sir.
17. 18. 19.
Present, sir.
20. 21.
We have some network issues, sir. 20.
21. 22. 23. 24.
Present, sir.
25.
Sir, 24 present, sir.
25. 26. 27. 28.
Present, sir.
29. 30.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32.
Present, sir.
33. 34. 35. 33, Harshita is present. 36. 37.
Present, sir.
38. 39. 40. 41.
Present, sir.
42.
Present, sir.
43.
Present, sir.
44. 45. 46.
Present, sir.
47.
Present, sir.
48. 49.
Present, sir.
50. 51.
Present, sir.
52.
So 45 is present, sir. Some network issues.
Okay, last I will give. 52. 53.
Present, sir.
54. 55.
Present, sir.
56.
Present, sir.
57.
Present, sir.
58. 59. 60.
Present, sir.
61.
Present, sir.
62. 63. 64. 400. 401. 402. 403. 404. 405. So anybody else missed attendance?
Sir, 50 is present, sir. He replied in chat box.
45 also, sir.
Yeah, one by one you can tell me. What is the number? 50,
sir, 50.
Na?
Yeah.
50.
Yes, sir. 50. Satej.
50.
45 also, sir.
45. Karthikeyan. Okay. Karthik K.
Sir, 50. Anusha DV.
15.
Yes, sir.
15. Banu Ranjan.
No, sir. Anusha DV.
Anusha DV, 12.
Number is there now. 15.
Anusha DV, Kamas, 1SG, 19, CS012. Haan, is this correct?
Haan, sir. Haan, sir.
Okay. B section, ready to give your attendance. So, dear nuns, are you able to see the screen? What I shared with your students, B section. B section students, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, Nitesh B.S. Prajwal P.
Present, sir.
Mudde Gowda Vinay. Muskan. 65. 66. 67. 68. 69.
Present, sir.
70. 71.
Present, sir.
72.
73. Present, sir.
74.
Present, sir.
73. Present, sir.
Which one is present?
74
is present, no?
73 also, sir.
Okay, 75. 76, 77,
present, sir.
78, 79, 80,
present, sir.
81, 82, 83, 83, 84, 85.
Present, sir.
86.
Present, sir.
87. 88. 89. 90. 91. 92.
Present, sir.
93.
Sir, 93 present, sir.
94. Okay, 94.
Sir, 92 present, sir.
92%, okay. 94. 95.
Present, sir. 96.
97. 98.
99. 100.
Present, sir. 101. 102.
Present, sir.
103. 104.
Present, sir.
105.
Present, sir.
106.
Present, sir.
107. 108.
Present, sir.
109.
Sir, 107 present.
108. 108. 110. 111.
Present, sir.
112. 113.
Present, sir.
114.
Present, sir.
115.
Present, sir.
116. 117. 118. 119.
Present, sir.
120. 121. 118. Okay.
87, sir.
Next.
106, sir. By mistake, you marked absent, sir, when I said present.
Okay. 106 is present only.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, tell me. Next. Okay, I will send the attendance for B section.
Sir, Sambram present, sir.
What you done? I will mark it. Okay, no issues.
80.
Okay. Thank you, students. Thank you very much. Complete your exercises in the weekend and complete every thing in the Google Classroom what I shared with you. Thank you very much.